really pleased to be with you. And it is my very first time on a Hollywood stage, so I start feeling like a part of the star system today. As every year, I bring around the world a subject that my clients, our clients at Dassault Systèmes, are particularly sensitive on. And this year, I've chosen to talk about platform. And the main reason why, actually, these platforms are eating the world. In our everyday life, whether it is private life or professional life, we have to cope with 100 platforms, whatever we do. And this is something that is really striking the world. It has become the platform, the biggest key word that is creating buzz everywhere, but especially on the internet. If you spend a few minutes of your life, actually, to understand what's happening and you do some Google Analytics, you may notice that in just 5 years, the search for the word platform has been multiplied by 10, since 2012, actually. What happened before 2012 is that the search related to the word platform were only given, or if you want, inspired, by the understanding that we, as industrial people, but as well as consumers, we were having the curiosity on understanding the phenomenon of GAFA, the Google, the Apple, the Facebook, the Amazon, or the Alibaba recently. Those guys that have invented, if you want, the platform for consumer good reason. Now, having said this, the reason why I'm here, it is to explain a little bit why platform has become such of a big buzzword, but especially what is the difference between those guys, other guys, my competitor, and especially the 3D experience platform. There are two main reasons why platform has become such of a big buzzword, and in every single day of our life, especially when we talk about our business, we need to think in terms of platform. The very first reason is because business is digital, or is going digital since a while. Economists actually are talking about the digitalization of everything, and they foresee that by 2020, 25% of the world economy will be digital. The reason why the economy is getting digital is because the majority of us, actually 75% of companies worldwide, are either investigating or already exploring, if you want, how to digitize their business. If I take one example of one of the value streams that we have to manage in our everyday life, that of manufacturing, I'm noticing everywhere in the world, from Asia to Americas to Europe, that there are not even one of the industrial sector that are not progressing towards the revolution, if you want, of the supply chain or manufacturing chain. Whether they are starting from very, I would say, mechanical type of supply chain, or whether there are companies and governments that are inviting their industry, if you want, to get through advanced automation. The only one point that is common to everyone and in every single economical environment, it is that we are going towards an era that is going to be that of smart industrial IoT, where we are all trying actually to transform our way of doing business from analog to virtualized. The second reason why, however, platforms are becoming so important is because business is going platform. And there is two main reasons for this, actually. The very first reason is the invention of the platform business model that has been done by the GAFA, as I was saying, and that has so much influenced the startup of the world that 70% of those that we call the unicorns, that are the startup that in very few time actually become over $1 billion business, they are all adopting, if you want, a platform business model. But it's even more striking to me the fact that apart from the startup, there is a large majority of large companies, big corporations, that are embracing the platform business model by partnering with industrial platform. Last year, if you have heard, if you want my speech throughout the forum worldwide, I was explaining the case of Procter & Gamble with the Oral-B toothbrush that has become a real smart device, where everyone can connect, and through an industrial platform, IoT platform, everyone can get services, therefore parallelizing the revenue stream from selling a product to selling a service online because of the usage of the toothbrush. So that is the phenomenon that is happening everywhere in the world. Now, before I go further, let me go back to basic, because I want to ensure that we do master what is the difference between a product business model and a platform business model. The product business model is that of the majority of us. We do create, invent, design, develop products, and actually our business consists in the fact of finding smart ways to go to market and therefore sell our products. That is a product business model. The platform business model actually consists exactly of the opposite. Those guys do not have products. They do not manufacture products. They do not have inventories. They do not manage a product life cycle. What do they manage is a platform. A platform that has been invented for trading, and therefore their business consists in creating fantastic ecosystem where other are creating products, and they only make business by transacting between me and the provider. That is the platform business model. The subject that I would like really to touch now, it is what is a platform and what is not. Because going around the world and talking to 12 different industrial sectors that are the installed base of the Dassault system and even the prospect of the Dassault system, I understood that there is a lot of things that needs to be demystified. That is the reason why I call this presentation Shattering the Myth of Platform. There are many myths, and I would like to analyze the three major, I would say, that I've seen, because I think that they are creating confusion in the world. And therefore, when we as industrial actors, we need to take decision and choose which type of digital enabler we want to have for our business, we can get really lost in the thousands of the buzzwords that are there. The very first myth is the fact that platforms are for business process automation. And the key question here is, really? If it was the big platform revolution just about having a digital add-on to analog process, then I think that we have done, all of us, a platform revolution in our life already 30 years ago, when computers were invented and where e-documents were capable of being created. So the digitalization of a business, it does not mean that we are actually creating from paper to e-paper, from files to e-files, or from analog process to digitally documented process. That is not the digitalization of a business. The real digitalization of a business happens when, in this moment that is the most information intensive probably of the history of the industry, we are capable of transforming our document into something that we all call data. So it is by mastering our data and by having a platform which is capable, if you want, to get into those data lake and try to find the right correlation on information, providing us with the modeling, with something that is processed out of our data and proposed to us as an optimized business process, so that we can talk about platform revolution. The second myth is even more interesting to me, because is what I heard that our competitors, the competitors of the Dassault system, are pretending to be. They are all point solution, and they say that a point solution can get transformed into a platform. Really? I know that Florida, it is the kingdom of Disney, okay? So 5 billion business every single year, 20 million visitors at Disney World. But really, unless we are into the entertainment business, we cannot believe that the frog can become Prince Charming. So a point solution that was created be it for PDM or for CAD, added with something that actually extends a little bit further the capability in that specific discipline, cannot be called a platform. In order to be a platform, something needs to take into consideration the fact that the business any industry we are in, from aerospace and defense to consumer goods, it is done by a multidisciplinary process that goes from the upstream to design to engineering to manufacturing to sales and marketing in an ownership and after sale. Those are the value streams that we need to master in order to ensure that the value that we have conceptualized at the very beginning is really brought throughout the process of the development of our product in order to touch the final customer in front of us. If those value streams get disconnected or continue to be disconnected, it is not the way of doing the right value creation chain. Thus, a point solution augmented the capabilities with some collaborative staff around can never, never, ever, if you want to provide you with something that really creates this flow of data that goes from everywhere into everywhere in a continuum that actually it is capable to inform your decision and therefore connect the dots in order to bring the value that you have conceptualized till the very last moment in the marketplace. The third myth that I would like to shatter, it is actually that any platform is an innovation platform, and it is the best for me, especially because in the Dassault system, we have really worked hard back 5 years ago when we announced to the world the creation of the Dassault system as the 3D experience company and the creation and the development of the 3D experience platform as an innovation platform. We sat for many years, actually, for many hours, and for throughout almost 1 year with the industry analysts of the world to analyze what it could be a platform and what it couldn't be, and what it is that makes a platform an innovation platform or a simple product development platform. We have invented, if you want, or helped the analyst think in terms of what's next after the PLM. And that is the reason why the IDC, the Gartner of the situation, and I think that some of them should be here with us today, have invented this terminology of innovation platform, working with us mainly. Then for sure they have worked with our competitors, but we have been the inspirer of this new generation platform thanks to the fact of the thinking that we were doing and that at the end has been materialized through the 3D experience platform. Innovation is not a linear process. Innovation is an holistic process. And that is the main question that you need to ask yourself. If you are into innovation, and I guess that there is not even one of our business and customers actually not wanting to innovate and continue having this breath, if you want, for its company, you cannot think in terms of just digitally connecting, if you want, your dots. What you need, it is to think ahead and think that it's not just a matter of connecting the value stream in a digital way in order to have a sort of enterprise solution for your industry. What you need to think, it is where the industry is going. And the industry is going towards extended, if you want, enterprise ecosystem. And this is the big novelty. And this is why platforms are today the only solution that you might choose, because otherwise you will be left behind your competitors. If I go further, after having shattered the three myths, I would tell you therefore that we should stop doing the metaphysics of platform and go back to basic. That is the biggest business rule that I have learned in my career. When the times are a little bit frightening, where we are really looking at 2,000 different transformative processes or industry trends, the best things we can do is stop, think, go back to the basic and start again. And what are the basic? The basic is the business. We are not there actually for doing a charity. We are all there, if you want, to participate to the worldwide economy with the revenues of our industry. So let's think of what business is about. Business is a social structure. So if we think to business as a social structure, we want to reach out to companies that are thought in the same way and that has developed platforms in order to embrace the social structure of business. That is exactly the reasoning that we have used at the Dassault system back 5 years ago when we have developed the 3D experience platform. We wanted to have a platform that was capable of embracing the extended enterprise trend that we were already witnessing at that time. And therefore, the 3D experience platform has been created in order to operate as your operating system for your company, powering, if you want, the industrial solution that you might choose from the portfolio of the SOSystem, but especially to help you embrace this incredible and extremely profitable moment of the platform business model, and therefore having you reaching out, coming out from the four walls of your industry in order to reach out to an ecosystem that can be much more innovative than you are, and that is the way of innovate today, because internalization of things, it is no more the case in none of the industry. So, after a lot of work, and especially thanks, if you want, to the define that the 12 industry vice presidents in the SOSystem are doing, a portfolio that is extremely, extremely deep, I would say, going from each of the industry to each of the segment of the industry to the peculiarity to each of the users that are my consumers, and therefore, who do I care or I cherish the most, we have created a portfolio that is present in every single value stream throughout the 12 industries that we serve. That it is the most competitive, and I can tell you, really, in the market today. And the second part, where the platform operates as a business model platform, it is there for you actually to help you understand how the supply chain it is changing today. You probably have seen some of my articles on LinkedIn, on eMagazine, where with the SOSystem, what we are, I would say, witnessing, but especially helping, is this movement from the supply chain to the concept of value chain to the concept of value network, where the supply chain gets not just virtualized, but the supply chain becomes something that really goes out from the four walls of your industry and helps you managing the biggest challenge of manufacturing that we are facing today. What is this? It is the fact that manufacturing today cannot continue to be nor an analog nor a digitized process, because manufacturing today is about the dynamics of the market, and therefore on-demand, not customization, not personalization, just the real on-demand production can only be managed through systems that are much more dynamic because they've been invented to be dynamic. Network of suppliers that are outside of your company and that you can reach out to them dynamically, choose them, qualify them, try them, put it back into your regular list, knowing that whenever you want to shatter the four walls of your industry, you can go in and out. It is the new way of doing supply chain today. It is the power of the value network. The 3D Experience Platform has a capability that we call the 3D Experience Marketplace. We have selected, for example, the biggest or the top demanded services of our customers. One of the services, it is called 3D printing, but it is machining as well. It takes into consideration any type of manufacturing that you might need. There are already big clients in the world that are starting using this service. You reach out to the marketplace, we manage for you if you want, through a list of pre-qualified industrial suppliers, not for prototyping, but for real manufacturing, from aerospace industry to industrial equipment, to including consumer good, we do take care of the full process so that you can really have a span into the new value network manufacturing of the future. I would like to conclude, therefore, by telling you that in case you are thinking to be lost, if you want, in this ocean of platform, think twice and think to the right keyword. It's not the platform, the keyword. What is the key word is business experience platform. That is how we have defined the 3D experience platform since the very beginning. It is no more the case of thinking in terms of point solution, engineering platform, big data platform, the manufacturing platform. We wanted to get it all. And not because we are extremely French, meaning we want to change the world, that we want to dominate the world, but because it is the world of today that needs to be connected. The value stream, every single value stream, if you want, within the value creation chain of an industry, need to get connected. It is no more the case that you do mechanical engineering without taking into consideration material science. That is the reason why, actually, of the several billion acquisition that we have done in the recent years. You want to reach out to a platform that has a scientific connotation from chemistry to bioengineering. Because that is would be the more and more needed, whether you play into aerospace, in transportation, in mobility, or in consumer goods. The 3D Experience platform has many capabilities, whether technological or business, and then it is structured in a way where the portfolio is an easy read. You don't need to be super dean sales actually to explain it to you. You look at it, you understand what you are buying. That is the most important, the clarity, the transparency, and the fact of knowing that this platform is not just a big data platform or an engineering platform, is all of this. Now, before really concluding, I would like to launch a video in order to wrap up what I've articulated for you in few visual. Let's launch the video.
In today's experience economy, consumers want delightful, unique experiences. The head of new product development at a luxury watchmaker knows this and is looking for insights on the market for premium smartwatches. She starts by using the information intelligence applications on the 3D Experience platform. She gets a complete picture of the market trends and opportunities. The platform aggregates and analyzes real-time information from her company's internal systems, as well as social media and news. Armed with this new knowledge of the market potential, she taps into an ecosystem of strategic planners, designers, engineers, and sociologists, and takes advantage of an open environment to turn their ideas into requirements for a differentiating smartwatch experience. When she onboards her team of designers and partners, it doesn't matter that the designer of the case uses CATIA V5, that the modeling of the wristband is done in SOLIDWORKS, or that the system engineer and simulation expert use CATIA and Simulia 3D Experience. The 3D Experience platform connects all aspects of the innovation process in a collaborative digital environment available anytime, anywhere. Using the 3D printing service of the 3D Experience Marketplace, the team connects with a qualified network of industrial printers around the world for prototyping or production. All they have to do is to input standard 3D printing specifications, review the list of possible partners, and choose the one that best meets their requirements. They stay in contact throughout the manufacturing process and arrange for delivery. In parallel, the team can reuse the original master 3D model to automatically generate the marketing assets to promote the consumer experience, such as print advertising, video commercials, and packaging. The result? A smartwatch with exceptional styling and detail, a unique customer experience in the luxury watch market. From the initial intuition to the ultimate experience, the 3D Experience platform digitalizes the entire innovation journey. 3D Experience platform, the business experience platform.
That's all, folks. As I would say, if you want to be into the star system of movies, my last advice is that we are here, we are with you, we want to understand better what you might need in order to tailor-made, if you want, the best configuration of our platform. I'm really sure that the 3D Experience platform is a peculiar animal, or I would say Prince Charming. So if someone else is coming to you pretending to be Prince Charming, don't go to Disney World, come to us. Thank you very much.